front to back.
You did?
I absolutely love it so much.
Oh, good.
This is the book on comedy.
Oh, well, thank you, honey.
Yeah. The book.
We wrote the book.
Now, how did you guys meet? Will you take me there?
Film festival. Yeah. I was working on producing something at the time, and his agents had pitched him as an actor for the project, and I was like, he's so good. I'm not going to do that to him. We'll find someone else.
And what was it that you saw in Elle early on that drew you to her?
I was working on a film, on a couple of films at the time, and they were both at the festival. And I remember the kindness that she showed me. But also, I was at a kind of also a weird place in my life, and she was this amazing positive influence on me from the get-go.
When you're adrift, what questions do you ask yourself? Out of curiosity.
What questions do you ask yourself? Well, I guess I think the first question you ask yourself is what's next? And how do I affect this change in my life? What's the next change going to be? What's this a transition into? And also it can be a little scary because you're not quite sure what the next family is going to be. And I wasn't sure necessarily. I didn't know that she was going to be the next family, but she was. She was.
Did you know that, like, he was in that place in his life?
Yeah, I knew.
A human, beautiful question mark?
And Drew knows, we've talked about this a little bit in the past, is Keegan was kind of trying to figure out what to do next, and he kept making up stories to kind of about why he couldn't do things that he really wanted to do. And I just had this thought. I was like, I don't know if anyone's ever, like, sat him down. Like, where are your friends? Like, where are the good friends that sit there and go, hey, buddy,
yeah. You
know, you're messing up. Like, you could do so much more. There's so much more value to what you have and what you can be in the world. And why are you limiting?
And I'm just very, very fortunate that I have a partner in all facets.
Yeah, when did it turn hot and sexy? was there always chemistry there?
It's funny, what I saw in Keegan in the beginning is he's talented, he's smart, he's funny. But there was one day, I don't know, I was like doing a little like internet dive or something, and I saw a video of him singing, and I was like, oh, he can really sing. I mean, this is amazing. I said he was like a sports car that's stuck in traffic. Like, he has all of this power and all of this energy, and like, what is he doing with it?
That's the best analogy.
Why aren't you out there going 120 miles an hour? Like, why are you stuck where you are? And so I was going to say I suggested he sing at our wedding, but I kind of was like, you are singing at our wedding. This is definitely happening. And he sang at our wedding.
What song did you sing?
I sang Tennessee Whiskey by Chris Stapleton.
Oh.
Yeah.
And he hit it out of the park.
When Elle looks to you and is like, I see these things in you,
yeah,
and you need to do them, do you believe? Do you trust? Do you, like, how do you say yes?
Sometimes it's a challenge. Sometimes I meet her with a little bit of resistance, or a little bit, a lot of resistance, some resistance. So, and she always remains patient with me because it's fear. It's fear that you're dealing with.
I'm riddled with fear. I have a fear disease.
You have a fear disease.
Yeah.
I think I might have the same disease, right? But there's this sense of what if I fail? And she's very much like, well, don't think of it that way. Think of it from the opposite way. Think about what if you succeed?
Wow. Just okay. Well, I understand.
You get it?
I totally do.
She's always up for an adventure, and sometimes it's an emotional adventure. Sometimes it's an actual physical adventure. It's just that she's always up for an adventure, and she inspires me to want to go on adventures. That's the thing.
I mean, you know. And you deserve that.